Michael here, and welcome back to a brand new video. And in today's video, I'm reviewing the brand new LEGO 2023 gift with purchase, LEGO Bionicle, Tahu, and Takua. How exciting is this? Bionicle is finally back. This set is absolutely amazing, captures what it's supposed to, amazing in LEGO system bricks, and two very nostalgic and memorable characters from the original Bionicle releases. Anyways, let's not waste any more time, let's get straight into the details. This is set number 40581, comes with 219 pieces, it is for ages 18 and up, comes with 0 minifigures, and you can get this for free with any purchase over $100 over at the LEGO store. Now, the model you see in front of you captures perfectly the original. We have, of course, Tahu, his signature fire sword, even his little hover thing board, and the lava which he was flying over in the first Bionicle movie. There are a bunch of references to the original action figure in this, and I am gonna try to go through a lot of them, but again, this set was meant for Bionicle fans. Now, LEGO fans, of course, it doesn't mean that if you're a Bionicle fan, you should get this set, and if you're a LEGO fan, you shouldn't get this set. Potato, tomato, Bionicle is LEGO, so it's for both, but it's mainly for Bionicle fans, because there's a lot of references that Bionicle fans will get. And I spend my fair time researching all the little references and Easter eggs. It took me about an hour to research for this video just for all the Bionicle fans out there watching this. So anyways, let's get straight into the details. First, we're gonna take an overall overview of him, then we'll compare him to the original. So over at the bottom, we have this nice little display, black border with some lava inside of it. Very, very nice. Of course, we have Tahu's little hover thing board, and he is just attached quite nicely with two Technic pins that sometimes come out with his feet. Oh, but yeah, as you can see, he just has two little Technic holes in his feet so you can attach him to the hover board thing. He's got some nice range of movements too, a lot of stuff done here with the Mixel's ball joints, very, very nice. We got them for the knees, we got them for the hips, we also got full waist rotation, full 360 degrees. You shouldn't be able to do that in real life. After all, this is a biomechanical creature, but still, this is weird, this is disturbing. Anyways, let's move on. For the left arm, we have a nice little elbow joint here, very, very nice. Again, that Mixel's ball joints allows a lot of range of motion. You can also pose them like that too, if you want. But there's another Mixel ball joint for his waist there. But full range of movement. You can also move the elbows. You can see for the right arm, we have Tahu's signature fire sword thingy. He's got the same elbow and another Mixel's ball joint to allow full range of motion. For the head, there is, you guessed it, yet another Mixel's ball joint to allow, again, a full range of motion up, down, all around. Of course, that is a very, very creepy thing to do in real life. Don't do that in real life. You'll end up snapping your neck. Trust me, you want to keep your neck. Anyways, for the face, we got that classic Bionicle mask thing. Whatever. Now, there is supposed to be a face under there, and there are actual Bionicle characters, but not in this case. We have a little translucent pink 1x2 there, which is supposed to represent something. I'll get that into that in the comparison. So there's some nice greebling there for the chest, but we've also got some even more greebling for the waist here. Some nice, again, references to the original Tahu guy. But anyways, we're done with the details. Let's take a look at the comparison for the original and the one you see before you. So at first, we'll move you to the side and bring over the actual Tahu Bionicle on this side. There we go. All right, it's comparison time. The original set was set number 8534. It came in a set called Tahu Toa of Fire. The original set's release date was 2001. Came with 33 pieces, 0 minifigures, and originally retailed for $7. Of course, now, if you want to buy it the actual original Tahu. Now you can get it for, lowest price I found was $55 on eBay for in a used condition. However, if you want a sealed version, you are going to have to drop a pretty penny. And by pretty penny, I mean $160. Anyway, for the packaging, it had a plastic cylindrical can. This one has a cardboard box. Now let's move on to the physical differences comparison. Let's start from the bottom, work our way to the top. The original had an ankle joint. This one does not. However, the original did not have knee. This does have movable knee. It did have movable hip, though. We do have that for the legs on the actual one you see before you two. This little ball on the chest is also from the original, but there was no waist movement on the original. This one, there is. One shoulder could not move. This one in the original could not move unless you switched it out like this, 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 or this. You could do that by just switching out a little, what is it called, Technic axle. For this one, though, on the original, you could move it. There was a little gear in the back, which you can twist, but they did with some of the Star Wars action figures that they did a couple of years back. And he could do, like, this karate chop. Nyam, nyam, nyam. I don't know why I said nyam there. On the left hand, the elbow couldn't move. Well, it could, but it was locked in place. But the wrist could, this one cannot, which I can understand. I'm sure they could have done that, though. But it does have the same forked hand as the original. For the right arm, the fire sword came with the arm in one piece. It was not detachable. Here it is. That's very, very nice. You could even put it in the hand of a minifigure and try not to commit arson. Again, the same thing here. It had an elbow, but it was locked in place. For the head, that same mask again, it could be taken off from the original to see the face underneath. It wasn't much of a face, though. And this translucent pink piece back here is meant to reference the piece that actually held the head in place in the actual set. However, it couldn't move like this unless you made some modifications. Anyways, that's it for Tahu. Let's move on to Takua. So here we have Takua. Let's look, of course, at the actual model, and then we'll take a comparison. We got some nice yellow feet, again, with the Mixel's ball joints here. Yum, yum, yum. Very nice. Full range of movement. Not full range, but quite a range of movement. For the arms, though, not a Mixel's ball joint. That's actually one of these one-by-one pan thing with a pin sticking out, so you can move the arms like this, which is still offering a lot of range of motion for what it is. This arm, we have a disc, which is referencing the disc launchers that some Bionicle characters came with on their arms. Again, we got that classic Bionicle face there, the mask. And in the back, he's got a little thingy, blue thing. And as you can see, he has a stud on his chest so he can actually attach to the back of Tahu, as we saw in the first Bionicle movie. As you can see, he just attaches snug as a bug in a rug there. He's sitting on the back, ready to shoot his disc. Oh, we're looking at... Ah! Anyways, let's get on to the comparison. Let's move you to the side and bring you to the side. So, Takua came in... The earliest Takua came in a set known as Takua and Puku, which was a little spider thing that he rode. It was set number 8595. Its first release was in 2003. It had 221 pieces, zero minifigures, and its original retail price was $20, and its packaging was in a cardboard box. Now, sadly, I could not find a lot of information on this little guy, but the only thing I do have is that in the set, he had blue feet, not yellow feet, as lore suggests. But yeah, that's it for Takua. There's also this little egg, rock, circle, thing, piece, I don't know. And that's it for this set. So, that was it for today's video. Hope you did enjoy. Please do not forget to like and subscribe. Helps with 50 subscribers by the end of the year. And see you next time.